The Scenic Airline Rail Trail is a part of the original New York and New England Airline Railroad. Back in the mid-1800s, the important cities of New York and Boston were already connected by rail and sea. However, travel by ship was still slow and risky, and the railroad options were either limited to the shoreline route, where trains frequently had to stop for drawbridges, or they had to take the roundabout trip across western Massachusetts and then down the Hudson Valley into New York City. A direct route across Connecticut would solve these problems. So in the 1840s, plans were drawn up for this nearly straight line through the air, or airline, between the two cities. Hence the name, Airline Railroad. The dream became a reality in the late 1800s. The railroad began carrying freight and passengers across Connecticut and Massachusetts. There were problems, of course. One of the major obstructions was the Connecticut River. A suspension bridge was proposed, but rejected due to cost. Other railroad companies used political means to prevent completion of the route. But the builders of the railroad persevered, and for nearly 80 years, the airline was a vital link between South Central Connecticut and the Boston area. Today, the Airline Rail Trail is a 50-mile-long recreational area. Portions of the trail are suitable for biking and cross-country skiing, while other areas are under development. The section we explored today runs from East Hampton to Hebron, Connecticut, a distance of about 7 miles. Let's explore the trail together. The bridge on the Black Ledge River is a scenic place to rest and enjoy the view. For many years, the bridge was an exposed steel framework, but in 2002, a new footbridge was built by cadets from the United States Coast Guard Academy, located in New London, Connecticut. Because of their efforts, we can now enjoy this scenic area. Here Joyce is standing atop the Lyman Viaduct. This used to be the Lyman Bridge, towering 137 feet over the Dickinson Creek in Colchester. But after the turn of the century, as trains got more massive, the bridge needed to be strengthened. A new bridge would have been far too expensive, so using good old-fashioned Yankee ingenuity, the solution was to simply fill the valley with sand and bring the ground level up to the tracks. Two huge tunnels were constructed to allow the creek to flow under the viaduct. Then carload after carload of sand was brought to the bridge and dumped into the valley. This process began in 1912, and it took over a year and a half to bury the bridge. Today, this massive earthwork is over 1,000 feet long and visible from space.